So there was a guy who sought union with God, Brahma. Brahma, God, the notions are very similar. And this guy had gone to many teachers, and they all said conflicting things based on the sacred texts of the people. Same texts, different interpretations, and they all conflicted with each other and argued, and each of them said their path was best. And so this dude finally went to the Buddha to get his insight on the situation. And it's interesting how the Buddha responded, because Buddha didn't place Brahma as ultimate reality. And here was this guy seeking union with God. And the Buddha doesn't teach union with God as the true liberation. But he helped the guy anyway. He didn't tell him, there is no God, your path is foolish. He helped the guy. He said, all these people arguing about what the sacred texts say, do they know Brahma? Have they met Brahma? And eventually the guy says, no, they don't claim to have met Brahma. I don't think they have met Brahma. And then the Buddha says, I know Brahma. And then he goes on to describe the places or the qualities of the place where Brahma dwells, where God lives. God lives in love. And this is seeking to help beings be happy, acting, desiring. And then there's compassion, which seeks to relieve suffering. All beings relieve their suffering. It's a desire and it's an activity. And then there's sympathetic joy, mudita. And this is the happiness we feel when we see that others are happy and relieved of suffering. And the last of the dwelling places, or the qualities of the dwelling place, is impartiality. This love, compassion, and sympathetic joy is spread equally. So all beings receive the same great love, compassion, and joy.